Hey everyone, Wink here, welcome back to Furnish 0.3, the Woolen update. I'm here in a little village for the occasion. It seems like the villagers have decorated their place. Let's take a tour of what is new. To begin with, there are now all variants of the amphora for all colors. Some have a little motif on the front side. Like when I place it, there is this face which has a little motif. It depends on the color of the amphora. For the lime one, it's the creeper head. Another work in progress feature which is now done is the shutter. It allows to close the windows in order to, well, make a shutter. It comes in all wood variants. Here is the oak one, the birch one, the dark oak variant. And don't worry, there is also a jungle variant and an acacia looking one. And now let's talk about wool. As you might have noticed, there are some buntings which can be hung to, create a nice ambience. It's pretty easy to craft, just a string in the furniture workbench. And you got three variants, the purple lime, the blue yellow and the red orange, which are all part of this scene. Then you might also have noticed the awnings, which are pretty useful to make nice decoration for markets or for little shops like this. Pretty easy to craft as well, just a carpet in the furniture workbench. Here is how it looks from above. As you can see, there's still a little lightning bug, which I hope to fix for the next release. Another wool-related thing you might have noticed is the sofa, which can be connected, which has multiple variants. For now, it's just an armchair. I can sit on it. And I must admit, it's pretty comfy. And of course, it wouldn't be a real sofa if it wasn't bouncy. So it's a block which can be connected to other blocks to form any shape of sofa you want. And now let's head to my house where I have a few things to show you. So of course I have a sofa, I can sit and watch this beautiful armor stand, which can be modified in Furnish 0.3. If I take a stick, I can add arms to it. This way I can equip him with a sword. It looks way more threatening now. Well, if I go into this room, it's my little workshop, but as you can see, there is a picture of my wife right here. Now, it's not really my wife, but there are new paintings in Furnish 0.3. And furthermore, you can use a painting on another one to change the painting, which is pretty cool, right? Another thing you might have noticed is we can now place carpets on stairs. Any kind of stairs and any kind of carpets can be placed like so. What a lovely bedroom here. And well, I should probably not tell you this, but you can also place carpets on trapdoors. Aha! Here's my little storage room, which is hidden, right? Well, I guess I store all my beings right here. And now let's head out of here. Oh, I almost missed it. I tell you, I can see a situation where this might come funny. Hi my good sir, how can I help you? I'd like to eat, I don't have any food to eat. Yes, you do. Oh. And well, it's pretty easy to place too. Just put a carpet on a trapdoor and it will work. It works on all kind of trapdoors, even modded one, like for stairs. It also worked on modded stairs, of course. It works also on iron trapdoors, which makes that you can control this via redstone, but not being able to right-click. Now, a few other things before we wrap up this video. Now you don't have to shift anymore to change the location of the handle on furnitures. It just depends on the part of the block you look at. Hey, Mr. Pig. Furnish also has a creative tab now, which is better because in previous release, everything was right here. That's it for Furnish 0.3. Thanks again for watching, and thanks for the almost 4,000 downloads. I wasn't expecting that so quick. So I'll see you in the next one. In the meantime, bye-bye.